Hi everyone, in this session we are going to learn the working of Central Asia and Unitary AC. We also discuss their differences, advantages, limitations and applications. So we start with Central AC. In Central AC, all components are grouped together at central control room where air is processed and distributed through duct to various rooms in buildings. All rooms in buildings are air conditioned by central air conditioning plant. Control room may be located in basement of building. Central AC is generally used for capacity more than 40 tons of refrigeration. Here plant consists of compressor, water cool condenser, air handling unit with cooling coil, expansion device. All components are carefully selected and installed. Here condensing unit, that is compressor condenser, are located in control room. Air handling unit located at center of building from which conditioned air distributed to various rooms. To distribute air to various rooms, duct design and laying is done carefully to minimize losses. Central AC system divided into two groups, direct expansion system and chiller water system, which is indirect type. In direct expansion system, air from space to be air conditioned is circulated through cooling coil, which is cooled by refrigeration cycle. Liquid refrigerant at low pressure absorb heat from air and get converted into vapor. Therefore, it is called as direct expansion system. Cooling coil of refrigeration plant is fixed in air handling unit and expansion valve provided very close to cooling coil. In chiller water system, chiller water or brine solution is circulated through cooling coil in air handling unit to cool the room air. Chiller in chiller package and cooling coil in air handling unit are connected by chiller water pipes or brine pipes to pump and circulated between chiller and cooling coil to air handling unit. Central AC is used to provide human comfort in commercial places like office, restaurant, banks or big buildings. It also used to maintain ultra clean atmosphere for precision work. Now next is Unitary AC. Unitary AC consists of two units. Indoor room unit consists of evaporator coil, evaporator blower, capillary tube. Indoor room unit situated inside room to be air conditioned. Here outdoor unit consists of compressor, condenser, motor driven fan. The compressor circulates refrigerant gas, increase in pressure and temperature and discharge to condenser. Condenser remove heat from refrigerant and gas change phase to liquid. Evaporator fan collects warm air and passes it over coil containing liquid refrigerant. Here fan system blow this cold air back into the room by lowering overall temperature of room. Unitary AC are mostly used for large offices and big rooms. In Unitary AC, the individual room temperature control is possible. It can meet exact requirement of each room, wherein central system cannot meet individual need of separate room. In Unitary AC, failure of unit stop conditioning of one room, wherein failure of central AC stop whole system. Now we'll discuss differences between Unitary AC and central AC. Unitary AC is factory assembled components, where central AC is site assembled components. Noise and vibration is more in Unitary AC compared to central AC. In Unitary AC, there is high capital cost per ton of refrigeration compared to Central AC. Unitary AC is small capacity unit up to 25 tons, while Central AC is large capacity unit above 25 tons. Duct work is eliminated in Unitary AC, whereas Central AC duct work is necessary. Installation cost of Unitary AC is less than Central AC. System failures in Unitary AC affect only one room, wherein Central AC system failure will affect all rooms. In Unitary AC, the individual requirement of room can be met, wherein Central AC it cannot be met. The accessibility for maintenance in Unitary AC is poorer than Central AC. Unitary AC located in every room of building, where Central AC located in basement or outside of building. The mass flow rate of air handle in Central AC is around 2000 m³ per minute, wherein Unitary AC it is less.